In this tutorial, we'll be covering Behavior Builder's actions. Now, an action is an event that occurs in the scene when a trigger is activated. For example, when the tap trigger is activated by a viewer tapping on the object, it can trigger a move action on that object or another object in the scene. So first things first, let's open the .real file supplied with this tutorial. Now, we see a little 3D aero button here. We'll use this button to trigger our actions in the scene. So let's start by adding a trigger to the 3D arrow button. With the arrow button selected, press on trigger and then select tap. We now have our actions available to us. There are 16 types of actions in Aero Desktop. We'll not cover all of them here today in this tutorial, but we'll cover a few. Let's first start by making the button animate by selecting the 3D arrow button and pressing the plus icon under the trigger and select play animation. Now there's a whole tutorial on the play animation action, so I'll not cover much of it here, so just follow along for now. If we look over here at the Behavior Builder options, we see the subject is the arrow button. Now we only have one animation set since when I created this animation in my 3D software, I embedded multiple animations into the GLB export. Now I did not have to do that. I could have easily exported out two different GLB animations or FBX animations and then set them here in the animation set by selecting the folder button and loading the animations. It's your choice on how you would like to work with your animations. Now, since I embedded my animations into one GLB, they are shown here in the clips dropdown. Let's select button press animation and then press the play button to see what it looks like. Hopefully that looks like a button getting pressed to you. Now we have no reason to trim the animation, so we'll leave the clip length as is. And I'm happy with the speed of the animation as well, so we'll leave that speed set to 1. The transition option here tells Aero to blend the animation with the next action or animation. We do not need that since our start and end poses are exactly the same. So I'll turn that off by checking the box here. And we'll leave everything else as is. The next action we'll add is a play image action. The play image action allows us to play an animated image, such as a GIF or a sequence of PNG images bundled into a single zip file. You can see an example of the zip file I used in the supporting materials you downloaded for this tutorial. To add the play image action, select the plus icon in the stack here and choose play image. Make sure you have the subject set to our PNG sequence called green rings. We want to play the whole length of the animation, so we'll leave the trim range as is. Now I animated this sequence in Photoshop at 24 frames per second, so let's set the speed to 24. Now you can preview this sequence by pressing the play button. Looks good. Okay, the next action we'll add is the play audio action. Make sure you have the arrow button selected and then click the plus icon here and select play audio. Move over to the audio clip options in the settings here and select the folder icon. Then select Audio Presets. Now navigate to the Electronics folder and select Beep03, which is really one of the best sounds ever created. You can actually hear it by pressing play. Good stuff. Now, leave the ambient box unchecked if you want your sound to be spatially placed on the asset it is assigned to, which we do. Now let's see how this button is working by going up to Preview and then tapping on the button. Looks great. So we'll use this button to trigger all our other actions in our scene in the following tutorial.